Hello, good morning. Welcome to lecture on how to carry out project on thedolite traversing. To start with, the student should be able to know the following objective, learning objective. First is how to calculate the conjugate coordinate and independent coordinate. Second is student should be able to calculate the corrections and calculate the corrected conjugate coordinates. Third, students should be able to calculate the independent coordinates. Fourth, prepare relation of Gates table. And fifth, students should be able to plot the traverse using coordinates. So, based on these objectives, we have to carry out the thedolite traversing project as a part of curriculum. So, we will go step by step. So, procedure. In order to carry out the thedolite traversing project, we require the following instruments: thedolite, prismatic compass, ranging rod, offset taking instruments, pegs, field book. Then, when you are going to the site, that is field procedure, you are supposed to follow. For that, you are supposed to choose the object as a building. And surrounding to the object, you have to consider minimum 4 and maximum 5 station points. And while choosing the station points, you should be in a position to see the minimum 2 points from a single station. For example, the traverse ABCDE is considered. This is a closed traverse. And when you consider the ABCDEA traverse, means you have selected 5 stations. And when you are standing at A, you should be in a position to see the forward point, the forward station, that is point B. At the same time, you should be in a position to see the backwards station, that is E. And similarly, when you are at B, then you should be in a position to see the point C. At the same time, you should be in a position to see the A station. So likewise, you have to see the visibility of 2 station points from a particular station. Then the field procedure, whenever you are considering this particular thedolite traversing project. So traverse is nothing but it is a series of connected lines. And when the series of connected lines, they are meeting at a single station, then the traverse is called closed traverse. So we will consider the closed traverse and we will start the procedure how to go for thedolite traversing project. So, for example, when you consider a traverse, let us say A, B, C, D, it is a traverse A, B, C, D, A is a traverse consisting of 4 station points. So, you are supposed to set the instrument, that is compass, at our first station, that is A, and you are supposed to take the 4 bearing of line AB. So once the 4 bearing of line AB is taken, then you are supposed to use the thedolite at station A, B, C, and D after carrying out the temporary adjustment of thedolite. So when you are setting the instrument at A, you are supposed to establish a line of sight with the forward point, that is B, and at the same time forward backward point, let us consider it is a D. So B and D, these are the 2 station points. At these 2 positions, you are supposed to hold the ranging rod. And then by setting the vernier A to 0 degree and B to 180 degree, you are supposed to establish a line of sight with station. And once the line of sight with station A is established, at that time your horizontal circle, that is vernier A, should read 0 degree and B should read 180 degree. Then you are supposed to tighten the lower peg clamp screw and you are supposed to loose the upper plate clamp screw, and you are supposed to direct the telescope in a clockwise direction, so that the point D will be bisect. So this particular observation may be taken with face left observation, and whatever the reading you may receive on vernier A and vernier B, from that you can calculate the angle BAD, because the instrument is located at A and you have bisected the first point B and last point as D, therefore you can get the angle BAD. So this may be a face left observation. By keeping the vertical circle of the vernier to the left of the observer, you have recorded this particular reading. Similarly, follow the same step. By keeping the vertical circle of the vernier to the right of the observer, again set the vernier A to 0 degree and B to 180 degree and try to establish a line of sight again with station A, station B, and after establishing a line of sight with station B, again try to tighten the lower back clamp screw so that the direction will be fixed and the angle will be measured from line AB. Then try to loose the upper plate clamp screw and arrange the telescope in a clockwise direction so that the point D will be bisected. And once the station D is bisected, try to tighten the upper plate clamp screw so that there is no further angle measurement. And try to find out the angle BAD by taking the difference between the vernier angle when B was bisected and A was bisected on vernier A as well as vernier B, so that you can calculate the oriental angle A. After recording the angle at A, you have to shift the instrument to the station B. You are supposed to shift the instrument to the station B, and again you are supposed to carry out the temporary adjustment. You have to do the centering properly. You are supposed to bring the vertical axis of the instrument over the peg which is marked at B, and then again you are supposed to set your vernier A to 0 degree and B to 180 degree, and you are supposed to establish a line of sight with the next point, that is C, next station point C. And after establishing line of sight with station C, at that time your vernier A should read 0 degree and B should read 180 degree. Then tighten the lower plate clamp screw so that the direction will be fixed, and again try to loose the upper plate clamp screw and try to bisect the station A so that you may get the angle CBA. So this particular reading is taken with face left observation. By keeping the vertical circle of the vernier on the left of the observer. Similarly, you may go for face right observation and write down what is the vernier A and B reading when A was bisected, and take the difference between these two to get the angle at B. Similarly, instrument is to be shifted at C, and C include angle at C will be recorded. Similarly, angle at D, you are supposed to shift the instrument, and again by establishing a line of sight with the next point, that is A, at the same time C, you are supposed to find out the included angles. Means you have observed all the included angles of a traverse. So, and at the same time, for the first line, you have recorded the four bearing of a line. So next step, you are supposed to calculate the corrected included angles. So by taking the summation of observed angles at station A, B, C, D, sum of all included angles should be 360 degrees. But depending upon the major values observed at station A, at station B, at station C, at station D, by making use of direct method of measurement of oriental angle, make the summation. And if the summation is exactly 360 degree, that is equal to, so generally we are going to take a check on included angles, that is 2n minus 4 into 90 degree, where n represents number of sides. Here the number of sides are 4, so 4 into 2 is 8 minus 4 is 4, 4 into 90 degree, that is 360 degree. Therefore, sum of employed angles should be 360 degree. So we have to check whether the sum of observed angles, whether they are 360 degree or not. And if they are more, then you have to subtract. You are supposed to calculate the whatever the extra angle you have recorded or observed in a traverse. And you have to distribute. You have to distribute it. So that is a error. And when the error is more, when the angle sum of all the angles observed is more than 360 degree, then you have to subtract the, you have to calculate the corrections as the difference between more than 360 degree minus 360 degree gives you the correction error, and then this error has to be distributed to get the corrected input angles. And whenever you are recording, whenever you are recording the included angles at the same time, you should be in a position to record the each side of a traverse. And in order to bisect or in order to locate the object accurately, you should be in a position to go for chaining, ranging and offsetting operation. And at that time you should start from station A, and then one person is going to stand at B, and depending upon the object on which side it is lying, let us consider it is lying on right side, then try to move along the line AB and try to stand with the open cross staff, and two persons are going to hold the ranging rod at A station as well as at B station, and third person is moving along the boundary of object. And when the line of sight, when the two line of sight, that is one is along the line AB and another is along the object, when they are going to make an angle of 90 degree, then you are supposed to calculate what is the foot of perpendicular. Means you are supposed to find out what is the distance from the initial station A to the position where you hold the open cast. So that is the distance. So it is the distance always measured from station, beginning station, that is station A, therefore it is called chainage. So chainage is nothing but it is the distance of any point on a chain line from starting station. Then shift the open cast up to the next station and next position so that the boundary of the object may be located, and similar procedure has to be adopted for line AB, for line BC, for line CD and for line D. And before that, you should be in a position to record the location sketches of station A, station B, station C and station D. So generally in a location sketch of a station point, we are drawing a sketches, and the sketch should be drawn with respect to north side, and then standing towards north and considering the side of a traverse, considering the side of traverse, you are supposed to draw a ray towards the direction of side of a traverse, and accordingly you should be in a position to show the traverse lines which are running in that particular direction. And then considering the nearby permanent object, you are supposed to draw the rays, and you are supposed to find out the respective distances from the station point to the permanent objects. And whatever the measurements you are going to note down for the permanent objects from the station point, that has to be recorded. And this particular sketch is to be prepared without scale, not to scale. And it should be prepared for each station for a traverse. That is A, B, C, D, you are supposed to prepare the location sketches. Next. Then, so we will go step by step. So procedure, then once after having, so whenever you are trying to calculate the lateral and departure for a closed towers, again there you are supposed to apply the check, and the check is you are supposed to do the algebraic sum of latitude, algebraic sum of departure, algebraic sum of latitude and algebraic sum of departure. And if the algebraic sum of departure is equal to 0, means there is no correction. Similarly, if the algebraic sum of departure is equal to 0, means there is no correction for departure. But generally, this is not observed. So you are supposed to calculate the correction. And we are supposed to find out what is the difference, that is, what is positive value, what is negative value, and that we are supposed to calculate the correction. And by making use of the three rules, Bowditch rule, transit rule, third rule, you can calculate the correction for each lines and apply to the observed latitude and departure values and calculate the corrected consecutive coordinates. And from the corrected consecutive coordinates, you are supposed to calculate the independent coordinate. We will see how to, what are the rules, and we will see how to make that particular calculation for further. Here, this particular slide is going to show the method, that is, you are going to find out the Bowditch method. And so this particular method is applicable when you are trying to record the angular measurement and the linear measurement with same precision, and therefore the formula is algebraic sum of departure or latitude multiplied by length of that side divided by perimeter of that traverse is the correction for the line. So correction, we are going to calculate the, by making use of this particular formula, we are calculating correction for latitude as well as departure. So C represents correction and B represents departure, and it is summation B upon into L upon summation L. L stands for length of line, summation L stands for perimeter. Similarly, CL equal to minus summation L into small L divided by summation L. Here summation L stands for algebraic sum of latitude multiplied by length of that particular side divided by algebraic sum of latitude, that is perimeter, sorry. So here you can calculate the correction for four lines AB, BC, CD. For the, at the same time, you are supposed to calculate the correction for latitude and departure. Similarly, second formula is transit rule. So the correction, so this particular formula is given as correction to departure oblique latitude of a line equal to algebraic minus algebraic sum of departure upon latitude equal to departure of that side divided by arithmetic sum of departure. So you can calculate the correction. So CD, C stands for correction, D for departure. So equal C, correction for departure equal to minus summation D up into D upon DT. D is departure of that side, whereas DT is arithmetic sum of departure. Then next correction we can calculate for latitude. So correction for latitude equal to minus summation L into L upon LT, where summation L is algebraic sum of latitude multiplied by latitude of that line divided by arithmetic sum of latitude. So this way we can calculate the correction, and we can apply, we can make use of the independent coordinates. So independent coordinates are considered. So in the coordinate, generally depending upon the maximum negative value of corrected conjugate coordinates, we are going to consider the, or we are going to assume the values of independent coordinate. So here in the in this example, we have considered the coordinate of AS 1500 and northing value as 1500. So the basic fundamental difference between the other type of traverse and the thedolite traverse is, in other type of traverse generally we came across the closing error, Whereas in case of theodolite traversing, whatever the correction is there, we are going to nullify or we are going to make it zero by converting the consecutive coordinates into independent coordinates. And the given traverse is plotted in the first quadrant. Given traverse is plotted in the first quadrant. So whenever we are going to calculate the independent coordinate for station B, then we will consider the previous nodding or sting for line. So whenever, for example, if I want to calculate the independent coordinate of B, then I will consider the independent coordinate of A, and I am going to consider what is the departure of corrected consecutive coordinate of AB. So here in this particular case, earthing, that is EA. EA stands for earthing, whereas NA stands for northing. So sting value is 1500 and northing value is 1500. So sting value of B is calculated equal to sting value of A plus corrected consecutive coordinate of A. So here the 1500 minus 17.07 equal to 1482.927. So this is the sting value of B. Similarly, northing value of B is calculated as northing value of A plus latitude of AB. This is corrected. So 1500 minus 0.976. It is 1499.024. Similarly, we can calculate the independent coordinate at C. So for that, we have to consider the previous independent coordinate, that is for B, and we are going to consider the at C, we are going to calculate the departure of BC. So independent coordinate of C equal to independent coordinate at B plus departure of BC. So we can calculate the earthing sting value of C as 1452.751. Similarly, northing value of C is calculated as northing of B, that is previous point, plus line BC, that is latitude of BC. So that way we can calculate the independent coordinate of C. Similarly, we can calculate the northing value of D as well as easting value of E. Similarly, we can calculate the for further calculation. And then finally, whenever we are considering the check, then again, whatever the value we are assumed in the initial, that is 1500 and 1500, that is to be checked as sting value of F plus departure of FA equal to 1500. And similarly, northing value of A equal to northing of F plus latitude of F. So we can calculate the, we can see whether these values are coming, those are adjunct or not. So this should be entered in the Gale's table. So here the Gale's table consists of station, length, input angle, corrections, corrected angle. So here the first five columns, they are going to represent whatever the details you are recorded in the at site, and the corrected angles you are doing the calculation in the field or in the office. Okay, so in the office you are going to calculate these input angles, and again from by making use of these input angles and by considering the four bearing of line, first line, you are going to calculate what are the whole circle bearing of each line. And from WCB, you are going to convert this WCB into quadrant bearing or reduced bearing to get the value of departure as well as latitude. So generally, departure is calculated as L sin theta, whereas departure is calculated as L cos theta. Okay, so accordingly, the values of consecutive coordinates are recorded. So these are from field observations, that is in this second step. Then you are going to calculate the independent coordinates like this: 1000 1000, here 4 points of station are considered, and here these are the corrected consecutive coordinates. In this you will observe the maximum value as 294. So therefore for safe calculation they have considered 1000 as independent value, and from this, as explained earlier, independent coordinates are calculated as, so whenever we are going to calculate the independent coordinate of B, we have to consider the what is the independent coordinate of A plus what is the corrected consecutive coordinate of BA. So we are going to subtract or make plus or minus depending upon that particular line. So we are going to calculate the independent coordinates for B, we are going to calculate the independent coordinate of C, we are going to calculate the independent coordinate of D. Then we will see all these calculations, how to convert the given WCB, how to calculate the given WCB from the first bearing of line. So here, in order to calculate the WCB, bearing of lines, next lines, BA, BC, BA, BC, CD, DC, DA, AD, and AB. So here the WCB of AB is taken 140 degree 11 minute and 40 second, and WCB of B equal to, since the difference between the fore bearing and back bearing is always 180 degree, therefore here minus 180 degree is done. So accordingly the WCB of BA is calculated. Then WCB of BC is calculated by knowing the incurred angle at B. In order to calculate the WCB of BC, we have considered what is the WCB of BA, and accordingly we can calculate the angle, that is WCB of BC. So WCB of BC, WCB, we have CD, WCB of DC, DA, and WCB of AB is to be checked, and we are supposed to calculate by making use of this. You are supposed to convert this particular WCB to the coordinate bearing, and then you are supposed to put the value of theta in this particular equation, that is D equal to L sin theta. Theta is value of reduced bearing, and L is length of that particular side. So for each line, we are going to calculate what is the departure of AB, what is latitude of AB. Similarly, for line BC, we are going to calculate what is the departure of BC. At the same time, we are going to calculate latitude of BC. Similarly, for line CD and D. So, line CD and DA, they are calculated, and then computation of independent coordinates are started. So, here the coordinate of A assumed are 1000 and 1000. So from knowing this particular value, you can calculate the independent coordinate of B, that is AB equal to AA plus DAB, where AB is independent coordinate of B equal to AA is independent coordinate of A, which is assumed, plus departure of AB. So that way you can calculate the independent coordinate of B for this thing. Similarly, you can calculate the independent coordinate of B for latitude also. So northing at B equal to northing at A plus latitude of AB. So that way you can calculate coordinate of B. So this is the independent coordinate. Similarly, calculate for C. Similarly, you can calculate for D. So here the coordinates are calculated like this. So this is the procedure how to calculate the independent coordinates And whenever you are going to calculate the independent coordinates, you are supposed to take help of what is the independent value of independent coordinate of previous point plus what is the latitude or departure value for the line at that particular location in a backward direction. So this is one typical sketch I have shown where A, B, C, D, E, these are the 5 points which are taken, and whatever the traverse which is coming, it is coming in the first quadrant. So therefore they are called as independent coordinates. Only here in this particular case, we are in the independent coordinate. Generally there are two coordinates in the form of northing and easting. So northing and easting, these are the two points. Northing is a distance measured towards, made parallel to north south, whereas easting is a distance measured parallel to east west. So by considering that, we are going to locate the exact position of A, B, C, D, E, A. And accordingly, by making use of that data obtained at site for chain edge and offset for an object, we can locate the interior object inside the traverse. And then by knowing the coordinate of A, by knowing the coordinate of B, by knowing the coordinate of C, by knowing the coordinate of D, and by knowing the coordinate of E, we can calculate the area. Here, this particular slide is going to show the method, that is, we are going to find out the body's method. And so this particular method is applicable when